Hello guys and welcome back. Here we are into game number two and we'll jump ourselves straight into the lobby and straight into the draft as well. Complexity Gaming against Wings Gaming here for ESL One Manila 2016 group stages. This is Group A and I'm joined by none other than Mopax himself. We had a little bit of a break there as Swindles was debating some rules and semantics, but it looks like everything's sorted and we're all good to get ourselves in. And this draft so far. Batrider Enchantress, Earth Spirit Tiny, all five gone. While remaining. Wings go back for the Invoker first pick again.
Yeah, so here we are once more. I'm trying to just double check here. Do we have a difference? Looks like we had all those remakes. They always mess. Oh, man, I have to find the one that actually is the draft. Oh, this is classic. Oh, now I won't get to see the draft because we did all pick.
We did all pick, man.
Oh, I hate that. Okay, I think this was the same, I want to say. I know the Tiny and the Earth Spirit were the same from Wings Gaming. And I want to say the Enchantress and the Batrider were the same, too, because we were talking about the Chen being a potential pick.
Yeah.
So, okay, all right. This is a little bit of an interesting opener. So, despite having the IO available, despite having the... what was our opener last time? It was the Doom right away. Also still available. And the exact same opener from Wings Gaming. We still end up with going into the puck. So maybe it's because they were thinking they wanted the puck come that second phase last game, and they thought they'd be able to get away with that. Maybe it wouldn't be banned out by Wings. So now this will probably force out, you'd expect, the Doom ban from Wings. And Complexity will have the first pick coming in the next phase. So if they want to go back into the Chen, they want to go back into an IO plus one in the second phase, this might be a good setup for that as well, right? Like, that's always the ideal time to go for your IO stuff. And with the way they've kind of let off, maybe it's going to slip past Wings thanks to that, you know, kind of the mind on the Doom. And potentially even like that lion.
There are so many things to take care of. You're exactly right. I'm just looking at this and thinking, last draft, you know, the Doom in the first phase means that your four roll, your greedy support is gone. It's out there. It's done already. There's a slight chance that maybe Swindles took the Doom, but it was pretty much always going to be in the hands of Z-Freak. But this leaves Chen open, leaves Enigma Dire side open. Could be a potential here from Complexity as well to add into this pushing pressure that they can apply with Nature's Prophet. I wonder in game number two if they will give Swindles the Nature's Prophet. Let him have it. And maybe give Chessie something a bit different towards Radiant the safe lane. That's always an opportunity for them. Their draft is relatively open still so far. And it's a Drow Ranger ban from Wings. And there's two ranged heroes on the field already. You don't want to get cheesed out by one of those drafts. Definitely not. And Complexity, what do you think they look for? Banning out here against Wings.
The old Wings boys, they're just such a versatile squad. They really will go for anything. If I'm looking at a Bounty Hunter, the Invoker, what offlaners are left in the pool? What is just that Tidehunter? The Batrider's gone. Let's get rid of the Sven. Another solid meta hero. OD's the biggest one still left, I guess.
Oh, Complexity. Vengeful Spirit. There we go.
Maybe they were thinking Drow. So this might lead into the Chen right now. So Venge, Chen, Pock, Nature's Prophet, finish it off. The Lone Druid's gone. What hero would they pick to end
Face
with that?
Face Voids is banned out as well.
Beastmaster.
Oh, of course. Of course there's a Beastmaster there.
Beast next. So they would go Chen. But Beastmaster would get banned.
You don't need to go Chen. If you've got Venge Beastmaster, Nature's Prophet, you've got a lot of push there already. You don't necessarily need the Chen. Then if one's banned, you can go for the Enigma. If the Chen is taken out of the game.
Yeah, that's definitely the play. Go Beastmaster next. I like that.
That's a good block pick by Wings. I mean, if we're thinking, you know, Complexity are likely to go Beastmaster next, then picking Beastmaster there for Wings is definitely a good shout. Dealing with the Beastmaster in lane, though, we've seen, you know, Disruptors and Oracles and heroes like this to try and kill off the boar and force that horned man out of lane. Vengeful Spirit, not going to be the best at doing that, but I guess if you pair up with a Nature's Prophet, if it is a Chessie safe lane Furion, then Beastmaster should get right-clicked out a fair amount.
Yeah, we were talking about how there's so many offlaners gone in the pool as well. Like, this is probably why Wings are also feeling pressured to pick this up. Because now you look at Complexity and maybe this will end up being this Windows Prophet simply because, like, what else is left besides Tide? Not that he doesn't love playing that hero, but it's basically that or Slaughter in terms of ones that you'll typically see them run. Maybe they go back for a 3-position Doom. I wouldn't mind that as well. Could also leave a little bit of mystery coming to the last pick for them. I mean, you would be lacking on the damage pretty heavily, I'd say, though.
And what about wings? Invoker, Sunstrike combos with Beastmaster's Roar as the game progresses. They've got the vision game on lockdown really now here, haven't they? With Bounty Hunter roaming around, the Tracker's there, Beastmaster with the Hawks. They've got Radiant plenty of those vision gating abilities, and they can try and control the Roche bit with these. But so far, it's very, very single target focused. They don't have a wide variety of wave clearing, especially early days. You know, Complexity here, they're kind of ramping up to somewhat of a push strat. And Wings, they're definitely lacking in the outspam and the wave clear to try and control their tier ones, definitely.
Yeah, and what's the, like, controlling hero that this Witch Doctor's working with? Because if you're thinking about it just for the Beastmaster, Oracle is definitely the key hero. I know they will play it too. It is something that I believe they've thrown over to Z-Freak in the past, where he kind of takes on the forest role, but it's just so good up against the boars, shutting them down, getting him out of that lane, forcing him into the jungle. Now, maybe they're a little hesitant to go into something greedier like that Doom, simply because the Bounty Hunter's there, and the lanes, they were very favorable last time, where they were able to bring that Doom down with the Faceless Void, but you're not going to have that pairing this time. There's no one else that really works that well with them besides, like, Enchantress, but she's also already gone. So, I can understand more of these laning supports. They're going to have a rough time applying any sort of pressure, but of course, you've drafted a Puck, so he's mostly just looking to be survivable in that mid lane. Make sure he's not going to be too affected by the Bounty Hunter, so... the more I look at this, the more I'm starting to lean towards that Swindle's Nature's Prophet. Survivable offlaner,
yeah.
Get Chessy something a little bit bigger. This seems to be a pretty passive laning stage.
And then for Wings, yeah, still looking at the Lion in the pool there. The double disables definitely could come in handy against that Puck, because for all we know, Complexity could start running around as a five-man. You need this, not only wave clear and AoE stuns, but a little bit more single target to start the fights off if you really want it to go that way. But it's Dazzle, the saving support here. And with that, Weave out onto his allies, buffing up all their armor, and maybe trying to deal with this right-click attack coming through from Complexity.
I think you gotta ban that Lycan now. I would be very scared of that. I don't think they've run it lately, but again, Wings is just a team that I think will run anything. I think they're very well-versed into numerous heroes, and just pulling a Dazzle out of nowhere, that kind of tips me off to be like, eh? You guys are thinking towards that little Wolf combo in lane. You've already got the Beastmaster and the Invoker. Reserve time. And why would you risk such little lockdown, you know? Maybe they just need some sort of a core with a stun. But they'll ban the PL Radiant instead. Team ban.
There's also that combo and Wings ban Lycan.
Alright, well, fair enough then. Maybe that's why Complexity didn't ban it. Maybe they were going to go for it. Oh, Drow and Lycan gone. That's a little bit sad now.
So if Lycan was going to be picked up, that would have been a Chessy Lycan and a Nature's Prophet for the offlane for Swindles. They do need something pretty beefy here. I mean, Juggernaut would be like the go-to carry for a lot of teams, remaining. Just with the healing ward, and you sustain these pushes into tier ones. You've got the spin remaining. To deal with Beastmaster in the early days of laning stage, and obviously Omnislash is a pretty good skill back Klinks. Against heroes like Dazzle. But Klinks is going to be their physical Radiant damage here. Eat up
I was
those
thinking either Slark or Klinks. I think Outcast. Was the one to go there.
Oh, hello.
And this is I believe Mineski chose one as well. They just had their first loss to Liquid, and I think they ran a Alchemist when I peeked over at the stream for a moment in our break there. But that's an interesting hero. Now, okay. Wait a sec. Is this safe lane, Alk?
Looks like it.
Oh, I don't like... that's got a... don't like that. Not a fan.
Mid-Alchemist. Mid-Alchemist is like all the rage at Frankfurt Major, because you get the Bounty Rune, the Insta-Bottle, the Poor Man Shield, the Quelling Blade, and all that. Is a nonsensical mid-laner. But safe lane Alchemist, we have seen a little bit from a few teams. No Diggity ran it a couple of weeks ago in the Epicenter qualifiers, I believe, for ERA. And he went for, I'm sure he went for like Midas, Armlet, Sanjinyasha. Like he tried to farm remaining. As quickly as he could, and he went for the full brawling battle Alchemist build. And it can get out of hand really quickly. But if it doesn't get out of hand really quickly, that's when you start to see that Alchemist, he requires that kind of farm. It's not just him, getting a load of farm and being like, hey, look, I've got a load of items. He needs all those items to be able to actually function as a hero.
Yeah, I think this game it's going to be, like, being in the safe lane, cannot rely. I don't even know if you take Gravel's Greed. I guess you obviously take that one point, but I don't think it's going to be leveled. It'll be Medallion, probably full Solar Crest into the Blink, max minus armor synergy, take Roshan, push all your towers. and try and win the game relatively early here. And just all that blinking concoction, obviously heavy damage using that physical unstable concoction. Well, it's not a very popular strategy. Who is it that runs it? It's Ping's team. Danish Bears? Yeah, they're the only ones that are, like, still running off.
When you said Ping,
days.
I was like, who the hell is Ping?
Oh, Ping. Pingvinchek,
yeah.
30 seconds to battle.
Well, game number two here in this best of three. Complexity looking to close it out, and Wings looking to tie things up. As Chessy over on the Clink's going to go invis and scout things out a little bit, but Dar Observer Ward already watching for this bottom rune spot while Bounty Hunter gets his own obs down. Let's just have a quick look at this vision. They see Complexity, or at least a few of them anyway, lurking around this area. And Limp moves himself forward with his puck, but Bounty Hunter still waiting over the Wings. The Acid Spray is thrown down in Shadow. Acid Spray and not Grievel's Greed at level 1. He'll get himself the Bounty Rune, or at least he'll wait for his mid laner to come and get it, but nope, not happening. Up at top, Chessy gets his. So safe laners get one bounty apiece, meaning the mid laners don't get anything for their troubles.
Well, I mean, wait. Wait, they gave him the rune and he didn't take it still?
Yep. Well, he went Acid Spray level 1. Like, he got Acid Spray through onto Complexity, then he stood on top of the rune and he didn't pick it up straight away. He was just, like, standing there going, Invoker, do you want... No, I'll take it then. I'll just
have to rethink that for a second there. It's just like, really? Still?
Well, dual lane at bottom. Swindled Nature's Prophet, Z-Freak on the Venge, trying to deal with the Acid Spray from Shadow's Alchemist, and of course, Ice on that Dazzle with the physical damage from Poison Touch and Shadow Wave, while Limp, Sentry Ward down, and Innocence is going to get scouted out. Sentry of his own, and it doesn't get counted out there. Limp misses out on the trade-off. ZY stands on top of it.
That was really risky to place a Sentry down when the Shared Tangle wasn't ready. Cooldown was still going.
How's
top lane?
Do
they have more? Well, that's it, eh?
Chessy Clink, Witch Doctor for Hanskin. And Beastmaster is level 1 jungling. Iron Talon, Boars are out. And Faith Bian just going to try and farm himself up through there. But bottom lane, this is where the real action is going to be happening. The 2v2 lane. Ice, Swindles. He's having a bit of a battle while they take out a nice little large creep camp there. Wings.
Well, this is really good. I feel like, taking a lot of damage on that Bounty Hunter. That's some nice harass, but I feel like they got away with picks that are more comfortable for Complexity, and I just feel like they're a little bit better running that could have been, I think, replaced with better heroes in their situations, like the Oracle versus the Beastmaster. Would have had an easier time at throwing him out of the lane, but they've succeeded in doing that with a Beastmaster, or rather with a Witch Doctor, and then the Klinks, the other hero that was left, was the OD. Synergize well with the puck, you get that little dream coil and that kind of damage, but this is a hero that they like running better, and although OD's renowned for forcing people out of the lane, they're still able to do it with the Clinks. So you achieve all the goals that you could ever hope for with a draft like this. Oh, that courier, it is coming, it is walking, it's going bottom first.
The boots and salve.
Oh, Z-Freak, please go. He's not gonna find it.
Not going to get it. So Bounty is now kind of your offlaner. He's not going to be that laning presence we expect from Bounty, just sitting up a top lane, leeching experience as much as he can. And this kind of alleviates some of the pressure from Puck, because now Limp can play a little more aggressively into this Invoker. You can see just plinking away with the right-click attacks and dealing a ton of damage back, and the phase shift off of that tower attack should be fine down the bottom, though the Bounty switched down towards the bottom lane. They're trying to safeguard this as much as they can, and Shadow has gone back into the Grievel's Greed. So he will be farming decently down on this safe lane for himself, but you just look at the last hits already, Mopax. 19-5, 17-1, 14-4. Three dire heroes up at the top, and these aren't jungle creeps. A couple of them are Swindles.
Like, considering how this lane started with all that harassment from the Bounty Hunter, Limp's having a very good time. Every time that the Bounty shows somewhere underneath that sentry board down bottom, he's able to get more aggressive again and still leading in that last hit in the mid. So it's definitely a favorable matchup for the Fox Force overall, but I think it's still pretty impressive considering the situation.
They're basically running two four-role supports at this point, with three-role. I guess he's jungling, but Innocence has hit his level 3, 2 points in Shadow Walk and 1 point in Janada. Not going for the early point in Shuriken at level 3 there. And there's Limp. He's been forced back to base by this Invoker. 14-7, catching up and now going to start overtaking.
Z-Freak's getting this rune, though. They didn't get here in time. At least he'll be able to deny it from the Alchemist being able to just walk down and grab it. And it was the Bounty, too.
Alk?
He took 2 points. I just don't get it, man. We're not gonna go for these runes.
He's going for the Falling Battle build. He's already picked up his helm, so he's gonna go for the armlet.
Yeah.
Try and fight up as much as you can. The Sunstrike down, Z-Freak dropped low, and Ice. There's no grave here. There is now, as he hits his level 4 just in time. Decent rotation in from Wings will clear up the Vengeful Spirit and get yourself the first blood. Dazzle, tail between legs, walks himself back down that bottom lane. But in the meantime, Chessie's still free farming up at top, and with Limp returning to lane at mid, this Invoker is in for a rough time soon.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Yeah, the big kickoff, of course, once you hit level 6 on your puck in the mid lane. You just want to get that initial kill with the Dream Coil. So your rotating supports this game. Not the best smokers in terms of roaming around there, but Z-Freak's already got it on him. And he'll just be able to waltz his way on in there. Might even end up bringing Hans. Probably not, though. It could probably just be Dream Coil into Venge Stun.
Oh, hell. Chessie's level 6, and this reminds me of Fear at ESL Frankfurt last year.
Yeah.
Level 6, you're not a gyro, you're a Klinx, but you've still got a ton of damage. And the ability to roam around at an early point in strafe. He has left top lane, and Hanskin being alone. But I guess it's just a threat, right? It used to be like the old Storm Spirit, and EG used it a similar way. You hide in the enemy jungle, and you farm jungle camps. You just stay off the map, and then if you do have a moment to strike with Swindles and Z-Freak being so active early on, find a kill on this Dazzle. It's relatively simple with the amount of DPS you've got, as well as shutting down the Beastmaster's jungling slightly.
Yeah, he's lucky that Chessie actually went into that camp first rather than coming right into the jungle. Would have found himself a free kill. But he'll rotate down bottom now. Obviously no detection back here. Oh, they're going to try it. There's the stun on the Shadow. Easy pickup. No time for the grave at all.
Shadow Wave was there, but Ice might have to grave himself. A great Sunstrike onto the Ventral Spirit will catch him. And Ice, the grave, close to death, but well-timed with a TP scroll away. Invoker found himself a kill from long range, though that Ion Strike from the heavens. With a Sunstrike killing off the Venge, but a 1-for-1, and you've killed the Alchemist, which is the most important thing. So his farming time reduced by a good 30-40 seconds there. And the armlet not going to be as fast.
Too. Oh, maybe he bought it and put it in his inventory when he got back to base. So I can't 100% confirm he had TP. But if he did, it could have just been like the grave for him. Top lane Hanskin, there's another Sunstrike. Boom shakalaka. It's gonna help get this experience up on your bounty hunter. Oh, now in the jungle. They're after him.
They want to TP top, I think, to try and kill off the Beastmaster. But Swindles, a little bit timid with that. And you're right, in the jungle, they force the Alchemist away. Shadows moving towards the top lane.
They still haven't used the coil. They were threatening it with Chessie there. Yeah, he's gonna find Ice.
Look at this. Chessie's just standing around in this jungle, not a care in the world. Level 7 Invoker means there's no double Forge Spirits just yet.
Oh, it's top lane again.
Wrap up time. Sunstrike through and Z-Freak very low, and he will drop in the end, but Swindles TP's in with a Dust Dance Sentry, but with no stun available. Innocence just TP's himself out. Wings, they're playing this very intelligently. 4-1, even with the great start the Complexity had in last hits and kind of laning dominance, Wings are still finding the pickoffs and still finding kind of advantageous trades across the map.
Yeah, and you can see with the vision they have in their own jungle, this is a really smart ward up against this Klinx. So they're seeing where he's rotating, they even get a sentry down here too, so he makes this little cut in from the jungle. But it just allows Ice to play safe and maybe bait a bit too.
Alchemist, he's so close to level 6, he'll pop it just here from that creep dying, and now
coil.
Looks like he might be out, and Limp doesn't go for the coil, realizing that the Alchemist is going to heal himself back up to full. That timing, that one dire creep that dies, perfect for them as bottom lane. Chessie picks off with a great Sunstrike again from the Invoker, and they're setting up perfectly for ZY.
Yeah, that was a perfect bait on the Chessie again. They saw him come through. They knew he was around there waiting for that Dazzle. And now top lane looks to me in trouble.
Ultimate.
Oh, that wasn't even a roar?
Shadow, he's got no ulti now, but Limp and Swindles, they're retreating very quickly out of this lane.
I wonder how they killed Chessie without a roar. He must have really committed onto the Dazzle or something.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
I thought for sure they would have needed it.
As this laning stage starts to close out and people are teeping around,
Z-Freak?
Looking for kills everywhere. Oh, dearie me. Shuriken in 3 seconds time. He's going to try and TP himself away. The boar doesn't give vision to Shuriken. Innocence. No, he doesn't get there. Not quite in time. Very close, though. And Z-Freak, fortunately for him, gets himself away. But Invoker, 9-minute Midas with the Bassy and Brown Boots. Invoker's going to be pretty happy about this, seeing as he was laying up against the puck.
Yeah. Well, I mean, you look at the kill score, you see the 5-1, but you start to look at the net worth graph, and that early farm from Complexity, it gave him a little bit of a buffer. So we're back to about zero. The question is, I feel like Chessy, he's playing it a bit risky, you know? He's kind of missing out a bit. Like, yeah, every single time, death pack, you're getting that farm, but he's not quite getting those pickoffs to really accelerate him into something special, like that early Deso. And now he might be caught out once again. Roar is up here. Hawk vision might not be enough, though. Lamb's nearby.
They have a dust on the bounty, but there are no sentries here. There's one a bit deeper there for Ice. Limp. And start things off. Chemical Rage. No, Alchemist. Just going to farm through the jungle camps. Innocence. Go and deward some sentries here from Complexity. But there's your armlet done. As bottom lane, Z-Freak and Swindles. Trying to shove in onto this tier 1 with the help of Chessy as he sprints himself across the map. Hansken has been given so much free time on top lane, though. Hits level 7 on his Witch Doctor. His item progression is looking okay, looking decent. So scary though when you're dealing with now a level 6 Beastmaster, the Roar is available and they're gonna start looking for these fights.
There goes your bottom tower though.
Radiant structures.
But they certainly have that on the side of Wings as well, of course. Only a single point into the inner beast though, he's a little bit, you know, kind of on the lower level, still trying to get those summons up to the higher points here. Limp sitting with a very hardy DD rune. We'll take that. Any sentries available? Well, they don't actually, and that might be what's making them hesitant here. They got the one over here, but they don't know where Chessy's coming in, and wisely so, they're going to back themselves back a bit here, and that doesn't allow the easy deny.
Chessy, I think he scouted out the Alchemist ultimate there. So Shadow's not going to have that in a couple of seconds' time as he moves himself down towards bottom. Ping has come out saying, hey guys, in case I get in trouble, but Invoker's in trouble. Let's swap back with a Dream Coil and Zipline. They get the Grave from the Dazzle. Now they turn around with the tracks. But I think the Invoker is pretty much rogered as the Roar turn back on the Chessy. The Dazzle drop as well with Faith Beyond. Oh my god, this cask is battling between the two of them. They've got nowhere to run, nowhere to hide. Complexity run over them in this team fight. 5-3 as the Beastmaster and Invoker both dropped over towards the front. Those Swindles hunting Ice Eyes and with the ult forward, they're trying to keep vision, but they don't even need it. Hunskin and Swindles pair up nicely. 3 kills to the good. As Wings, they had no answer for it.
Yeah, they even actually goofed a little bit on that combo. This has been very popular lately, the Venge Puck. You Dream Coil, you swap to force the snap, but they were just a couple of units off there. In the end, though, Grave, not enough to save his life. So, all goes according to plan. You get this nice early aggression with Limp. This will be. Is it done? Oh, it's done. Oh, the Blink Dagger. Yep. Oh, that is just nasty.
Delivered out to him. Swindles, phase, drums, 1400 gold. Can start looking towards your maelstrom or whatever you want to go to. But it's still that case of Chessy, right? 1400 in the bank. But yet to really build up into that Desolator or any of these bigger items we expect from the Clinks.
I wonder if Swindles will go like the kind of general build that he's been going every single game lately with the phase, drums, into the mech. It seems like it would be a good game for it, actually. Like, you have a Klinks, it's just so much heavy damage. Now, you could also be looking for that control, of course. Like, it would be still a great Orchid game. You've got an Alchemist, you've got an Invoker, you've got a Dazzle. I think that would still be my first pick, just being Swindles.
Let's go for that one. Wouldn't be too bad. Wings, where are you guys heading? Smoked up Invoker and this Beastmaster. Drums is being built up there by Invoker, but they want to try and pick off Swindles and... the track initiation. The Sunstrike's gonna be there and they get the easy kill. Meteor's even thrown out to try and stop the advance from Complexity as they TP in, looking to maybe save up that Nature's Prophet. Ice. Dream Coil. Limp, he just catches him. There we go. Illusory Orb and Silence. Still on cooldown though, as Ice is getting right clicked down slowly but surely. And now he goes for the Grave. Ice still keeping himself alive through this, and Limp, he's taking a lot of physical damage here with the Sunstrike forward. Limp is dead!
Wow,
dear.
Well done.
That Dazzle. So strong.
Yeah, you tend to underestimate just how much damage that hero is able to do. Solid right clicks, you know, but... yeah, smoking up from Z-Freak. Are they going to try and do this using Chessy? It does appear so. Two of them smoke. Oh, no! Excellent timing there from Wings. Great game sense.
Oh hey, they're all missing off the map. Let Sunstrike Roshan. I mean, Invoker's been on point, honestly.
Yeah, he really has.
How are we looking for Alchemist? 3,600 gold mod packs. I said it was going to go for the battle build, but it doesn't look like it's going that way. Armlet into Radiance seems to be his plan.
Haste!
There's the relic. Interesting stuff. A little bit of a deviation from the build then. They're not going for the armlet into SNY and the treads and all that. Instead, going for the Radiance afterwards. And I guess against the right-clicking heroes here from, you know, Complexity with the Clinks, the Nature's Prophet, Swindles with the Vlads completed. Not the Orchid or the Maelstrom. They're looking for a little more early game fighting power from themselves. But they still need this Chessy Desolator, and they'll move themselves back into the Roche Pit once more. Sunstrike, where are you, Invoker? He's got it ready and invoked. Not sure they know exactly what's happening right now, though. They're backed up very deep in their own Radiant Jungle. Bounty Hunter's not really scouting out or giving any vision. They've got the Hawk. The Hawk is going to see all and get himself over this clip and actually notice that Complexity are halfway through Roshan at this point, with Alchemist and Dazzle farming up a top lane. I don't think there's any real way to contest this anymore.
No, it'll just be some sort of a trade coming out here. So, yeah, it's interesting. It goes to the Vlads, but should be helping out the whole team. It's going to grab that a little bit cheaper than the Mechanism. And this armlet into Radiance, it is something that's been done pretty often in the Chinese scene. It was very popular right up until Shanghai. And so it looks like Wings are still A-okay with running it. It was still typically done in the mid lane, so it's a little bit unusual to see it out of the safe lane, but a great timing, still 15 and a half minutes. Can't really complain about that, especially considering the way this has gone. He's only 0-1 and 1.
Swindles, roaring, Sunstrike, and they've cleared him up nicely. But yeah, the armlet into Radiance builds before Frankfurt, sure, but Then it kind of switched. There was Armlet Blink, Armlet Medallion came back, Armlet Phase Boots, Sand and Yasha. It became the real popular build. And seeing this is a real sort of revert back to your roots as Wings, maybe. There's Alchemist stacking up the gold now. See exactly where he heads into. Not sure if it's the Manta Octarine, and that's the way to go to try and split push this out a little bit more and draw your attention away from your towers and your base, because Invoker still needs a little bit of time to ramp himself up further. Of course, he's still looking for your boots of travel, your Aghanims, your Blink, a bit of mobility, but definitely that Ags to get his Wex points up a little bit further and buff his ability to actually contribute massively in team fights.
Speaking of which, like, that's kind of what we saw as the failure of Wings, I'd say, last game. Sort of a similar style with the Bounty Hunter here. Complexity, they're not as far down as they were in the game before, but when it came down to those big AoE abilities and everything, they were kind of lacking that big synergy and cohesion. But now you're rocking a Invoker, and you don't have the best setup. There's no more Ravage. Now it's just going to be the single target Roar. So things are going to be a little bit more difficult, and they've traded that out, though, for a little bit more of the split push game to kind of match up with this Nature's Prophet. And of course, we had the PL last game. This game will be Chessy on that Klinks. And you can only imagine he'll be heading into that Manta style next. Swindles, again, might be paying the old gank toll. See how deep they want to go. Limp's ready, though.
They know the bounty's there, and they've got him with a Dream Coil and a good dust out from Swindles. Do secure it, and there's your BOTs out for your Alchemist, so it looks like he might be heading into that Manta Octarine route. Ice Ice, he kind of left that one alone. The Alchemist bailed out as well, but a good TP away will get him out of the grasp of Chessy, who was hunting desperately for an added extra kill there. Now you're looking at a Veil on the puck. Lots of early game momentum based items here for Complexity. They're not looking to scale into late game. They want to fight, and they want to fight now.
Yeah, once you pick up that Vlad's, it's like, yep, let's go. I don't know if he'll go for the Maelstrom right away, if he does end up going back from the mech, or if he just goes right into the Orchid too. I think any of those are totally viable for him. The Veil done for a Limp. And Chessy, I mean, you've got Aegis, you've got Desolator, this is the time to be a Klinks. Trying to find that one free pick. Oh, he is just diving here! Chessy!
Three hits, Ice Ice, easy. Not quite just dead. But he dives in past the tier 2, and Complexity without a care in the world, they kill off both the Dazzle and the Bounty Hunter.
And this death pact right into the tower with the Deso. This is gonna be so much damage.
Tier 2, not long for this world. Yeah, look at it go. The HP destroyed by Complexity. On the rest of them, Wings, what do you do to stop this? You've got a Necro 1 on your Beastmaster, nearly Necro 2. Well, he's got the money for it if he wants to buy it up now. But Invoker with the Boots of Travel, Alchemist with the Boots of Travel. They have this global mobility.
Was that another tower? Goodbye.
Yeah. Like, with the BOTs on these two heroes, sure enough, you've got that global mobility to get yourself across the map. But where across the map do you sit yourself? Because Alchemist is farming jungle, scared and paranoid about who's going to jump on him. Invoker needs to push out mid lane, and they've got to defend bottom as well. Oh, smoke up. This is the move here. Straight through into that dire side of the map. Top right quarter. Alchemist.
Hanskin might
hold his own down towards the bottom lane. Hanskin, but it's a good dream coil in from Limp. Blinks in, starts to blow. Death Ward as the ice has cleared up. There's no grave! There's no heal. Dazzle's gone, but the sprout back. The Death Ward still keeps on going. And Invoker's picking out of the sprout as well. The Alchemist finally kills off Chessie, but the Aegis Immortal still allows him to return to the fight. And Complexity just run rampant over every single hero from Wings. Shadow and Innocence, the last two standing. But dear lord, Complexity absolutely ripped them a new one.
And talking about these items that they've amassed here, there's 4k on Swindles, by the way. And double buybacks, time to abandon shift. Swindles just immediately TP's home. He'll make it out free. The tracks are there. I don't think they can chase this down, though. No track on the Chessie, thankfully. He would definitely be the prime target they would love to get on top of. How do you get initiation on someone besides this Beastmaster? Like, does he have to go back for the blink? Do you try and go for like some sort of farmed up blink here on the shadow right after the manta? You feel like they need something to actually try and capitalize on these tracks, because right now they just like run away.
Well, this is the issue, right? Beastmaster had like 1800 gold, but they just spent 3 buybacks. Invoker, Beastmaster, and Bounty all bought back. So if you're looking at this Complexity early game lineup, early game itemization, very, very pressure focused. It's 8-12, but they've done the damage now. Because we're not going to see a fast blink after Necro 1, which I think is what the Beastmaster was saving for. So I was looking at him thinking, yeah, Necro 2, he could have it right now. But he just kept on saving money. They're going to go for another smoke and try and capitalize maybe on their ultimates coming back off cooldown and utilize this roar a little more. But Necro 2 is finally delivered for Faith Beyond.
Yeah, I'm sure that was the plan. There's like no question, I would say, at this point. You'd be looking to head into that blink. Because you're up against a Klinks, you're up against a Nature's Prophet. You have your Bounty Hunter, you gotta try and get something going here. Try and keep these kills up, because the whole game it's felt like, prior to that fight, Wings have been ahead in terms of kill score, but every time it was like Swindles getting solo picked off or something with four heroes smoking up, and the whole time everyone else is just farming on the side of
good.
There's
swap.
That big swap.
Shadow, that Ethel ends on bench paying off dividends, and Shadow absolutely demolished the Death Ward with that minus armor from the Vengeance. Dream call forward, Limbus caught them both. Sentry wards, where are you? He's got the Veil down onto two, the Grave under the Invoker as well, but Dazzle's already gone, and now the clear up.
Oh, he's got no TP.
Another one as Invoker walks back through the sentry. He's invis, he's hiding, but a wave of terror from Z-Freak clears up the kill. One little spell now without an Invoker for 60 seconds. Beastmaster, no roar expended. A Vengeful Spirit buying a full Blink Dagger at 22 minutes. And Complexity will look to push high ground at this point. What did Swindles buy? A Maelstrom. TP's himself down towards bottom lane. Starts destroying creeps. The American.
He bought that straight up gem too, didn't he?
Yep.
Yeah, he thought that swap coil was scary before. Now with the Blink Dagger, it's wherever they'd like it to be. 30 seconds till it's up. They don't want to pressure too heavy here. You don't want to lose anything. You know, everyone's a little bit low. Mana. And track again only onto Chessie and still no chase potential.
I just go around D-warding. They can regen up all they want. Get Chessie, the next Roshan. We'll find out when he spawns in about 30 seconds time. But Limp, he's rushing very quickly into this Aghanim Scepter, currently sitting 600 gold away from it. Just bigger and better items for every hero on Complexity, while there's no mech for Innocence. There's only the sustained heal from Ice Ice. Well, Invoker might even start to think about a BKB, never mind his Aghanim Scepter or Blink Dagger. This is looking really rough for him.
Yeah, and this is just... it gets so absurd once you have that Aghanim Scepter on top of the puck. We've been seeing lots of teams running this. It's with the bring back of puck, you know, just stronger mids, controlling tempo kind of mids, Queen of Pain being back. Teams have been looking towards this Ventral Spirit right into this Aghanim Scepter, because how would you try and win this game as Shadow? Like, after your Manta, maybe you'll get a BKB so you can actually try and fight, or if your Invoker wants to get stuff done in the fight, he wants to try and get a BKB. Well, of course, your Dream Coil is going to pierce that, and then if you swap them through it, thanks to the Aghanim Scepter, it's a 4.5-second stun. It's ridiculous. And that's, of course, at max level 16, which Limp is also closing in on.
So does Alk not want to go the full route and finish off his Octarine Core? Do you think BKB is going to be the game-winning play here?
I think he kind of has to go for the Octarine. It's just more of, like, you know, maybe in a better game where he can possibly already have something along those lines, like halfway to the Octarine.
Think about that, BKB. Roshan is alive.
If he gets caught out, like, BKB or not, he's just dead already, so... I think Octarine's still the way to go if you actually want to try and win this game.
Hey,
you're right, though. Roshan back up.
And the DD rune as well, if the Klinks can go and take that one up. Looks like Chessy, they've got vision with his ward. They'll see the DD.
Oh, yeah.
He's going to poke his head in, see the Roshan's alive, and say thank you very much.
No radiant vision.
Oh, he spots Roshan first. He's going to look out to see if there's anyone hiding around.
Pack.
He wants to death pack the Wild Wing. Make sure there's no one lurking around on the high ground, and with his freshly purchased Blink Dagger. Oh, Sunstrike perfectly timed again. It's going to be vision. But the trouble is, vision is one thing. Massively teleporting every single one of your heroes into the Rosh pit is quite another. Especially when Roshan's already dead. Wings, they know about it, and they know they can just push out a little bit further on these side lanes because Complexity are all around that pit. But you've got this Aegis Klinks now with a Blink Dagger and a Diffusal Blade. He's going to jump on top of any hero he wants. Is it three hits or is it two hits here? One, two. Disgusting. Absolutely disgusting.
I mean, DD ruined.
Like, honestly, let's be real here. That is horrendous to watch. A poor little Dazzle.
And they're on Swindles.
Oh, do they have it? They do indeed.
Strike Dota.
But in the meantime, your bottom lane getting shoved in by the rest of Complexity. And the Klinks, he's hunting, he's invis, he's up on the high ground. The Necro 3s, they burn through a lot of his mana very quickly, but he's still holding on to Aegis of the Immortal while Invoker is top. Shoving into that wave. It's like Complexity. Without their Nature's Prophet, they will retreat back and defend this tower. It's a smart move across, though. Maybe expecting Invoker to come back and farm one of these lanes. The two hits in on the Courier takes it out. And that was Shadow's Octarine Core. Very close to done. That was his full Soul Booster actually completed. He does still need that Mystic Staff. What you seems gooding in chat?
Oh, they're just, you know, things had to be done.
You banned, you banned someone. Oh, there
no,
we go. Hansken caught. He's dead. That's one good pick. One good track kill for Wings as they get themselves a lot of money. But on the back end, there's the roar onto Chessy. Still going to the Immortal Loan and try and come through onto this one with the dust thrown by Innocence. Keep vision over onto that Klinks. But where's the rest of Complexity? A TP out from Faith Beyond will get him back to safety. coL, they don't push too far forward. Patient, disciplined. Just make sure you sit back, recoup, get yourself back up to full HP, full mana. And with Aegis lasting for what, another 3 minutes? They've got plenty of time to go push high ground here. Dire's bottom
tower is under attack. Yeah, you can see they had Chessy kind of on lockdown, and they're just like, alright, we gotta run. Like, we can't even afford to burn down this Aegis right now. I mean, if that's scary, kind of out in the middle of the map, I don't even know how this next high ground siege is going to look. Quick TP from Shadow seems to be okay.
I mean, that was risky, honestly.
Yeah, the acid. Well, the Necros will spot out Chessy, but there's no one else here.
This is the thing, though. Necros are being used to scout because of this Chessy Klinks. Faith Beyond not going to have them for another minute now. Complexity. Four staff on Puck. Is he going to try and look to snap the coil on his own?
Yeah, I think it's that. It's also just an item where, like, we're looking down the game. It's deep initiation up against the Alchemist, too. Like, think about when he was... Does he have his bots yet, too?
He does.
No, he doesn't, actually.
Oh,
the Puck? No, I was thinking about Lim.
It's also really good against the Beastmaster. If someone gets roared, you know that Sunstrike Meteor are going to be landing on their heads, right? So you let them get roared, then you force them away so the combo misses. Another thing that Invoker has to pay close attention to. Complexity. This Naked Rack's at bottom lane. The Glyph is here for Wings. Damage output, though, is insane. Tier 2 is dropped up at top. Melee Rack's down to half health, and Wings looking maybe to try and fight this one through with Chessy getting raw. The swap back is there, and Limp. Room coiled down onto a number of them. Bounty is dead, but Wings might still be able to look at this one go, and you're right, the full staff is there to snap the coil. Complexity take the melee racks and Wings. They have to advance. They want to try and get something out of this, but there's still Aegis on Chessie, isn't there? The blink back, and now the self-stun. Shadow, he's caught in the spell, the jump forward to the limb as well. He's going to try and get the silence down, the orb is there as well, but the damage output isn't enough. Magic taking him over. There's the armor toggle through from the Alchemist. Witch Doctor, he's the one to drop from complexity. Wings, they hold onto their ranged barracks, and they don't lose any further heroes.
Well, the first Rax goes down. Yeah, Chessie, a little bit of a... kind of comical blink into the trees there. With the track, they were able to advance a little bit and actually get that one kill. But of course, still went for complexity. Very happy with how that turns out. And as long as Alchemist is in the base, they're going to be very pleased, right? He's the only hope at getting these things pushed out, keeping them in the game a little bit longer. But what are you even delaying for? Some miraculous, like, Aghanim's Octarine, or possibly even just... I guess it's Refresher at this point for the Invoker. But it's 3 minutes even. I feel like 3 minutes is too long. Like, maybe you win that one fight and then they'll just be right back knocking on your door and slapping down your racks. So maybe the Octarine's actually the way to go.
Oh, dude, look at this build from Swindles as well. They full assault cuirass. And I was just looking at the Alchemist. He's got 8+5 armor. That's not a lot of armor against a Klynx with a Deso. And now against an assault cuirass for the Nature's Prophet. It's not even counting the little wave of terror from Seafreak that he's throwing out from time to time. Alchemist. The thing is, at this point, he needs so many different items that the Manta Octarine Core, like, okay, it allows you to farm up quickly, but it hasn't allowed you to farm up quickly enough, and you don't have enough item slots to actually fill with the items you need. And in the meantime, you know, this complexity lineup, 7,500 net worth ahead, they've got all the big items they could possibly want, outside of maybe Aghanim's on the Witch Doctor, but 15k experience lead. You've got level 13, level 14 on your two supports, while over on the Radiant, level 9, 11, 11. Even on your three-roll Beastmaster, who's being absolutely eclipsed here.
Oh, can they get the Ranger? Oh, they missed it!
Oh. So they have Reveal, the TPN, the gem, Swindles. Not going to come in for that, so swap back. Where is the gem, man?
It's on Z-Freak.
Z-Freak has it.
Yeah, they tried to do like some cute little swap plays, but... Did he... I didn't have BKB. I guess they needed to defusal first, but it was just a little bit too late there from Chessie to actually get like the slow and allow Limp to catch back up.
Shadow being tailed a little bit by Chessie. This is a ballsy movement though from Wings as Invoker and Bounty push down on this bottom lane, not knowing where complexity are because they're all grouped up in this Radiant jungle at this point. Invoker, he's been spotted and the shout is coming out. Let's go for this kill and then jump in straight onto Beastmaster as Limp used into the air. Tornado is there and ZY on the retreat out. The tracks start coming through. And Complexity, maybe a little bit too aggressive in this team fight as the rollback onto Swindles means the swap has to come from Z-Freak. The stun up Yan and they've killed off the Beastmaster. But in comes Alchemist, the big tanky man looking to fight this one through. Where's the Klynx? Where is the damage output from Complexity?
Oh,
he's sprinting away, he's running, he's retreating, but he has to death pack through a little wolfie. Swindle with a great spell forward and Dreamcall back from Limp as well to try and catch out the Invoker and the Alchemist, but the meatball lands onto the Complexity's heads and Shadow keeps on battling through it all. Wings, a teamfight win at long last for them. Not a big one, but they got something at the very least, and they held the aggression outside of their tier threes, which is the most important thing.
Yeah, that's true. They're showing they can actually, you know, do something outside of their base. They do end up with a net worth win here. And quite a bit of experience going near Invoker too. 1,300. Can't really count that out. Obviously, Invoker, every single level, gonna matter. Trying to claw himself up into that big old AoE 360. Little disarm for himself. Still a ways away. Looks like, what? Four levels. Yeah, he's having a rough go. He's got the max exort rocking here. Zap!
Oh, yeah, he does. Chessie, after the BKB, maybe look for a Hex or something for yourself. You are needing that single target lockdown at this point to try and catch heroes like the Invoker because you've got the damage. It's just the catch potential at this point that maybe you're lacking a little bit. Wings. Blink for Faith Bian. It's nearly there. And a Shivers card for Shadow, so not the Assault Cuirass. Against the attack speed of Klynx and Nature's Prophet, I guess that's pretty good. Interesting though that he goes for that instead of the AC, and now another smoke from Wings.
It's all about the actives, man.
Of course.
Octarine, gotta get max value.
That's true. Tornado just about clips. Hanskin's Witch Doctor. There's no one to save him as he is taken out of the game, but that's two cooldowns expended there with Tornado and Meatball both thrown. Wing's still looking to fight into this, though, and complexity. They've got a hawk. They've got two hawks, actually, watching their every move.
Yeah, Lim's pretty far back for this. Like, obviously, he's the one who has to kind of kick this off. Oh, they pop out of the smoke. Oh, but Lim's not quite in range.
I'll just try and shove out this wave and a nice little shimmy there. Jump in, jump out. By Lim's puck. This is where we start to see Wing's grasp a little bit of control back from complexity. And split push is starting to work out a little bit, but still dealing with Limp Puck blinking around and looking for this invoker. Not quite going to catch him. The blink away from ZY, but Ghostwalk is there. The Dream Call still catches him. They need reveal. Oh, he comes out of invis and now he's dead. Absolutely shredded by complexity.
Yeah, the gem was on Limp, it looks like, actually. So he's like, oh, Seafraid, not going to find him. He was close to catching out that Dazzle as well. All right, where's our Aegis? It's about to pop, and it looks like that train will be in there to scout it out. So this will be hopping right back onto Chessie. Yeah, drop the ring. You can grab that. Hey, there's our blink. We got it. Is a tower going to go down? Oh, no deny.
Alchemist, though. Oh, dear, the roar onto Limp. They've caught the puck, but the damage output from Chessie swap back as well, saving up Limp. He face shifts himself away from this in the sprout. It's onto Shadow as well. Limp force stabs himself out, and the puck is still alive. Shadow's caught in the trees. They're still trying to chase down a few on the back end as this invoker buys back and looks to fight. Oh, the chase continues. Tornado only onto one, though. Hanskin, he is going to be the sacrificial lamb here as the Witch Doctor is ripped apart. And complexity, they force buyback on invoker. And honestly, with a roar on top of that, they have to get this Roshan.
I mean, that's pretty solid for them. Oh, look, Z-Freak just like, hey, there you go. Take it. Give me a little hand here. I mean, this is definitely one of those games where the experience graph really tells the, you know, a better story since it is the Alchemist. You look at his net worth and he's almost doubled the puck basically at this point. 30.5k. But his next closest ally is also nearly half that as well, so. It's always hard to judge with Alchemist just how much, you know, he's actually getting out of these items, especially when it's this build. This is definitely not a mega fighting heroes and winning games build.
Like
it's
how inflated space. How inflated has Alchemist made your net worth there? That's a fair amount. That's still good vision game here from Wings. They don't necessarily need Observer Ward's complexity. Maybe trying to make up for the fact that they don't have any vision-giving heroes outside of the little treants from Nature's Prophet with these nice little wards across the mid lane and down towards the Radiant Jungle. Still the bottom racks to finish off, though, but I think Complexity might be looking for bigger and better things. Tier 3 top, Tier 3 mid. Try and close out this game. Because, of course, they did itemize relatively early on for the Veil, but I guess Limp's Puck now with the BOTs, the Aghanim Scepter, Chessie. I still think that Hex is going to be a pivotal part here for Complexity to try and win this game. There's a free bottle there. There's a free... Chessie, there's a free bottle there. Destroy it. Kill it.
Oh. He's going to get a scurry up top. No, it's only TPs.
Still
so disappointing.
Still a courier, though. The axolotl.
I wonder if he'll die for it.
See, Freak. Oh, full staff back, and yeah, he is definitely dying for that. Pay for your insolence, Mr. Bounty Hunter. You cannot get away with a free courier snipe like that.
I mean, he doesn't have a blink. Yeah, there's just no way, because Limp has bots, so there's zero chance that there's a creep way nearby that you're going to escape with your life. Once he saw it was the TPs, it was probably the wise decision not to go for that, I'd have to say.
I'll take that.
Where's Chessie?
Sorry. Pass the gold around. Yeah, he's looking for the Dazzle, probably.
Is it still a 2-hit on Dazzle? Maybe 3 hits now. Gem for Alchemist, and I guess he's going to give that over to someone else. He doesn't have the item slots to actually hold it in, but he finishes Abyssal Blade not long ago. Nice little added lockdown against the BKB Clinks, and of course, the slippery little devil is the puck. Hanskin. Aghanim Scepter, 1300 gold away, and I honestly, once Complexity get that like next tier of items, the Hex Clinks, the Aghanim's Witch Doctor, maybe Swindles gets a Hex of his own and sells his drums or Maelstrom, that's where Wings will really start to struggle. But for now, there's a little bit of leeway time where they can split push, they can get a bit of farm across their heroes, And Invoker with now Aghanim's Octarine and the Aegis. Complexity don't want to fight into this just yet. They'll just be biding their time and waiting to get those items and not rush forward and put themselves to a bit of a misery situation where Wings can advantage and exploit. Maybe turn this game around some.
It does kind of seem to be that they're approaching that almost window point, though, you know, where Wings will eventually, I would say, come online a little bit heavier. Now, the whole Puck-Venge scaling thing is actually pretty solid. The fact that it's always going to be BKB piercing a massive amount of damage, but it is an Invoker. You still have that nice lockdown of the Beastmaster. Oh, looks like Hanskin. Nice save from Z-Freak.
Shadow still wants to go in for this one, though, as the stun's thrown out, but the roar over towards the back. The Sunstrike lands on the Chessie and Limp, and they're being demolished. Invoker has killed off one there. Chessie,
oh, taken out of the
game. There's a buyback available, but Swindles, he is in the thick of things, getting absolutely walloped down by Shadow. And Wings, looking for Puck.
Oh, Limp. Cannot lose Limp.
Four staff. He's got Blink. The Blink. Tornado is there. He jumps himself away. There's a haste rune up at the top spot, but he have to try and TP himself out of this one. The buybacks are ready for coL. They're going to have to be forced here. Caught off guard and good utilization of the Roar allowed Wings to just walk through that team fight with ease.
All right, they found a new aggression now that they have this Aegis on top of their Invoker. Allowing them to actually push themselves further into this map here. Will they ever be able to get into like one of these bigger objectives in terms of the racks? That's a little difficult to tell for now. That next tier of item certainly will be the decider, especially that Scythe. Assuming that it is Scythe and not like Lotus Orb or something here for Limp, but picking off that Invoker, picking off that Alchemist. Our Aegis, it's expired now, so. Oh, this is decent timing here for Chessie, but no one else will be able to help him. Just a haste rune.
4 minutes or so until Roshan respawns. A decent timer. Both of these teams, first Aghanims of the game.
Oh, I hadn't even considered that.
Dazzle Ags. Now they start to ramp up even more. He can switch one onto Invoker as well, the Beastmaster. They've got these heroes for the Aghanims. Invoker can obviously... This is the thing, because Invoker Ags is such a pivotal item for him. That item slot being freed up is actually a massive deal. Because then he can have BKB and Refresher, or Refresher and Hex. Or Refresher and Refresher and Refresher. Just being able to fit something in on top of that Refresher Orb is huge for the Invoker. And now they're scouting out with a Hawk, looking for the jump onto someone. There's the Tornado again, catching Hanskin. The EMP, the swap bag. Z-Freak tries to save his mate, but the stuns come through onto Hanskin, and he's just two hit down, even with a Sunstrike thrown, but the roll back. Chessie, Chessie's clicks. Oh my god, the Abyssal Blast there as well. Shadow clears him up, but there's no buyback for the clicks. This might be a way into the game for Wings. The tier 3 gets ripped apart. They need the creep wave to come in first. Alacrity. They do. They do more packs. The Hex is
lit. I mean Complexity.
Oh, Complexity. I don't know, but I definitely know the Wings have got the damage to take this Rax down. Limp and Swindles. He's going to try and get up on the front lines. He might have to try and give this one up. A nice phase shift there to dodge out from the Alchemist Concoction. There's the Dream Coil to slow things a little bit. But Rax are falling. Wings, they've found their way back in. The massive swing here of momentum is Complexity. They're going to lose their Rax. And now you know that Klinks doesn't have buyback. You're like 90% sure. No buyback, Klinks. Or at least you, like, you definitely know because it's on cooldown. They've still got 4.5 minutes.
Can't kill anyone because you have a Vlad's... Ancient Prophet. Like, it's 42 minutes in, but he doesn't have Daedalus or anything like that. I'm sure Wings are positive. There's no way any of them are dying.
Could they not have gone for tier 4s there? They get 1.5 lanes of Rax. Very safe play here as they retreat themselves away. Bottom lane, that's what happens. Full lane of Rax did go. The ranged Rax finally gets taken out. The Complexity. How much trouble are they in right now?
I would say a heap of trouble. Like, that next Aegis is definitely the most pivotal thing for them. Getting that on top of Chessie just made these fights look so easy. He'll have the 8-second BKB this time, but it's just that Abyssal Blade. Every time Shadow's getting on top of him, they're not able to burst anybody down quickly. Every time that they were winning at the start of the game, it was always Complexity hopping in, getting that first big pick. Getting someone just out of the fight right away, knocking down that 30k Alchemist at the time, who's also approaching into 40 at this rate. And I guess puts it on Beastmaster next, right? Yeah, that's a good item. It's very solid.
There's your Hex Invoker as well. So the next Aghanims to come out for Shadow is going to be for that Invoker, and he can swap his own Aghanims and get a Refresher Orb in that slot. Nature's Prophet, 4,300 gold. He still needs to buy himself an item. Now the Demon Edge from Chessie. Daedalus, Monkey King Bar. I guess Monkey King Bar is going to be pretty good up against this Radiance of the Alchemist. But Complexity. How do they actually go across their river at this point? Because a smoke up from Wings is going to do just that, looking for the aggressive play again, and they want to fight outside of the Complexity base to try and get tier 4s, maybe even just end the game here. Hansken, and you're going to get caught again. He's so close to this Aghanim Scepter Mopax. He's 50 gold away, Mopax. Oh, he's dead again, Mopax. He's 500 gold away now. Roshan respawns in 20 seconds time, and Complexity, they are in a spot of bother.
Oh man, these fights. It's like, if they're just missing one piece, things look so different for Complexity now. Obviously, the last time it was Chessie himself, the man, the myth, the only damage. Once talked about 20 minutes ago, the last time it seemed like he was able to just stand still and do a fight. Swindle's still not committing to an item here. They're going to lose that last outer tower. This can help secure Mega Creeps if they manage to make themselves back into the high ground. The Treant still scanning at Roshan. The question is, do they want to go? I'm sure they probably scaled it with the Hawk already.
Oh man, this weave. Look at the armor stack up. Alchemist, yeah. Plus 34, plus 30. Oh my god, this is so much freaking armor. They do get the snapback in the Dream Call and the stun concoction. He's going to be able to launch this one though, or is he? Self-stuns the good chain from Z3, catches him out. Chessie's trying to rip him apart as well. The tornado flies across. The Shadow is still alive. He's still popping out damage, and Chessie's a pistol plated up. He is taken out of the game, and Complexity with no buyback on their clicks might just have to call it soon. The Death Ward's cancelled out. The cold snap is there from the Invoker and Wings Gaming. They've brought it back. They are taking game number two here, it looks like. They are unkillable with a Grave, with a Wave, with a Weave coming through as well. Innocence gets jumped in by Limp, but he's still not dead. The cheese keeps him alive, and they turn back onto Limp's Puck as well. Oh, Swindles. Oh, Swindles. Dead in his base. And Wings Gaming go for tier 4s. GG is called game number two here in this best of three. It's all tied up, one apiece.
Man, that is just some Alchemist gaming. So we talked about the item choices that came up from Complexity here, where the Vlad's obviously Nature's Prophet, but it was also like that Force Staff came out from the Puck. You already had the swap to kind of do your little combo, but it definitely seemed like they had cash. They're like, all right, everyone spend your money. We're going high ground. We're winning the game. That was kind of the play, the plan, you know? This Aether Lens on the Hanskin, well before any of the Death Ward, Aghanim Scepter, not the most common thing to go Aghs first, but I know, it just seemed like they kind of spent all their gold and they're like, all right, we're going to win. And things didn't quite work out that way. They looked so dominant, but eventually, this Alchemist draft and combined up with the Invoker, the Beastmaster, like these heroes, we talked about how like that window was closing for Complexity. And a couple catch-outs by Chessie, like his positioning in those last like three or four fights just never was in that right spot. And they finally had that swap into the base. They couldn't even do anything. So, there we are.
Game 3 coming up soon. We'll take a short break and we'll be right back.